effort to pen the armed groups of the Manipur as terrorists. A statement by the Secretary of Publicity of the Front, Dilip Laisemba, released here said the attempt of Indian government to paint Manipur groups as terrorists to the visiting Myanmar Army Chief General Than Swe will not bear any fruit as Myanmar will not accept it. He said India, in the name of fighting terrorism, was painting the armed groups of Manipur as terrorists and trying to prevent cross-border flow of arms and cadres of the groups. However, Myanmar will not accept this as the relation between the people of Manipur and Myanmar is far deeper than with those of Indian people. Myanmar clearly knows the 60 years old relationship Manipur has with India. It also knows the hidden agenda of India to break up Myanmar, he added. Laisemba also raised the agenda of the cross-border talk between two countries in context of Manipur. He said the issue that needed to be discussed between India and Myanmar was the issue of delivery of essential items, which have become scarce following the economic blockades. It should not be that of flow of arms and insurgency movement. The question to be asked, he said, was, did India take steps to ease the pressure of food scarcity in Manipur in its talk with Myanmar? He asked India not to sidetrack from the real issue and concentrate on terrorism. Recently built building of Tangkhul Naglong TNL was inaugurated yesterday by Lieutenant General K.S. Yadav, AVSM, BVSM, SM, GSM, DGAR of 10th Sector Assembly Rifles at Ukhrul. The inauguration ceremony was attended by K.S. Yadav, D.G. C.A. Krishnan of IGAR South, W.C. Sag and people of Ukhrul. Before the inauguration ceremony, there was a warm reception of the presidium members by the students of the region. K.S. Yadav stated that living in harmony is the best livelihood. We should live as one, cooperating with others, he added. A mobile shop at Singhamay supermarket has been robbed by breaking the locks last night. Properties worth rupees 20 lakhs have been reportedly robbed. The shop belongs to one Yambem Boinau of Singhamay Okumlikai. This shop deals in Nokia handsets, CDs and other electronic items. A cash of rupees 10,000 was also taken. In connection with the controversies of the Imphal Urban Cooperative Bank and reappointment of its general manager Y. Ningthemzao, a meeting of the association of the bank was held at Uripok Laikhutlampi Sanglen. A decision was taken to solve the problem rightfully by related authority and continue normal functioning of the bank. A one-month-long fashion embroidery training program organized by People Development Society New Chekhon was inaugurated today by Chairman of ICMKH Borkishore at the office of the society. The training program was also attended by Assistant General Manager of NABARB, M.S. Sarangnath. K.H. Borkishore said that the training program will help the trainees to be self-sufficient and a regular amount of income. In connection with the blood donation campaign for the HIV positive people by Desam since 2004, a blood donation function was held at Blood Bank of Jenims. Many students took part in the blood donation program. Vice President of Desam Islamuddin said that it will be very helpful in the treatment of the poor and needy people of the region if all the people of the state participate in the social works with sacrifice. A 6-week training program on preservation of foods organized by Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Development Institute Takel concludes today at Sangai Pro Youth Development Club. Food technologist T. Sana Jauba emphasized on the topics of the additives in preservation of foods. Before we conclude, let's have a quick look at the headlines once again. SPF partner CPI lambast government over MOVC scheme failure and opposition stalls parliament for fourth day over price rise. That's all we have for now. Thank you for being with us. See you tomorrow at the same time.